And another major company has been in the dock in France over the hacking of computers belonging to environmental activists. The energy giant EDF has been handed a €1.5 million fine and had two of its executives sentenced to prison for engaging in a spying operation against Greenpeace. A court in Paris also jailed the head of a firm hired by EDF to compile a dossier on Greenpeace UK at the time the firm was attempting to enter the British nuclear energy market. Our science correspondent Tom Clark reports now from Paris.
It's the world's largest operator of nuclear reactors, not just in France, but in Britain, where it has more than 5 million energy customers. But EDF has just broken another record. It's received one of the largest fines in French corporate history for hacking into the computers of environmental group Greenpeace. This court today ruled the company was morally responsible in a case of industrial espionage right out of the pages of spy fiction. Two former executives received prison terms, and the company was fined €1.5 million.
Alors, c'est une décision, lourde de conséquences.
This verdict has serious implications. The punishment is extremely severe. The €1.5 million fine given to EDF is one of the largest ever given to a company in France. All the accused have received prison sentences, which signifies that the court wanted to show the importance and severity of breaking the law in this way.
The conspiracy began here at a cafe in Place Saint-Augustin. The court heard how in 2005, former French intelligence officer Thierry Laureau, head of Paris-based security company Cargus Consultant, arranged a meeting between computer hacker Alain Quirot and the then director of security at EDF. The computer hacker told investigators that at the meeting at the cafe, he was directly asked to help gain access to Greenpeace's computers. He was subsequently sent a list of email addresses and keywords to help target his attack. He even described how he used the back of a napkin to draw out how a Trojan horse virus would be used to breach security systems and get access to confidential documents. Placed on the computer of a senior Greenpeace campaigner at their Paris headquarters, the Trojan horse allowed the hacker to log individual keystrokes. That gave him access to passwords, through them, emails and confidential documents. The hacked campaigner was working on EDF's new nuclear plant design, the EPR. It's facing cost overruns and delays where it's being built in Normandy. The same design is due to be built in the UK. The campaigner is now a member of the European Parliament.
The will of EDF was to know what type of information Greenpeace and myself had about the EPR, and especially the safety and security problems of the EPR. Now it's not only an industrial bankrupt, it's not only a financial bankrupt, but it's also a moral bankrupt.
Seen here leaving court, a hacker Alain Quirot, the head of Cargus Consultant Thierry Laureau, and the two former security chiefs at EDF, Pascal Durieux and Pierre-Paul François. All were handed jail sentences of up to 3 years for their part in the hacking. During the trial, it also emerged Cargus drew up a 100-page report on Greenpeace UK for EDF. Given EDF's key role in Britain's future energy supply, we asked the Department of Energy and Climate Change for a response to the judgment. They declined to comment. So too did EDF. Its lawyer told us today it would appeal the judgment. Tom Clark, Channel 4 News in Paris.